A reading from the book of the prophet Job. Job said, "Oh, would my words were written down. Would that they were inscribed in a record, that with an iron chisel and with lead, they were cut in the rock forever. As for me, I know that my vindicator lives and that he will at last stand forth upon the dust. This will happen when my skin has been stripped off and from my flesh I will see God. I will see for myself with my own eyes, not another's, and will behold him. My innermost being is consumed with longing." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please stand. Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Today's scripture passage is taken from the Sermon on the Mount, as written in St. Matthew's Gospel. Through the passage of the Beatitudes, Jesus teaches us that the true path to salvation is one that consists of humility, charity, and brotherly love. He teaches us that these are the keys to the transformation of the inner person. The Beatitudes are less about who I am and more about how I see everyone else. They are about seeing others through the eyes of Christ. It is through our faith and belief in God that we experience peace, joy, love, compassion, and a freedom of spirit. But these are only an indication of things to come. Eternal life is simply the fullness of life in the kingdom of God. As Christians, when we speak about heaven and the resurrection of the body, we do not speak about these things because they give us consolation and strength, but because we believe them to be true. Our Lord assures us that one day he will return for the resurrection of all those who believe in him. Through the waters of baptism, each of us becomes the Lord's own special creation, where we become united with him in his suffering, death, and resurrection. Our Heavenly Father did not leave us powerless in the face of death, but he gives us victory over sin and death in and through his Son, Jesus Christ. We believe that as Christ is the way, the truth, and the life, there is a dwelling place for those that follow his commandments and who love one another just as Christ has loved us. During these difficult times, we need to rely on each other and come together as a Christian community and support each other. We know it's very difficult for people that can't be together with their families and that are being quarantined for one reason or another. But I think it's important that we keep our faith and really put our trust in the Lord, who will see us through. So this evening, I invite those at home to gather together and talk about the experiences they had with their loved ones and share those special memories, especially the beautiful moments, the joyous events, or actions and words that have left a mark on our hearts. Please stand. Listen, Holy Father, to the prayers of your church gathered here, that in these moments of sadness, anguish, loneliness, pain, and despair, we may offer you our petitions from the bottom of our hearts. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis and all the bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and lay ministers that they may face the difficulties of this pandemic by following in the footsteps of Jesus. May they break down all the barriers imposed by fear and mistrust in our society. We pray that they may not lose hope, and that we are always ready to meet our most needy brothers and sisters with love, service, and compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sensitivity of all political leaders and legislators, that they may have compassion towards all groups in our society, especially those who are homeless and those that have been afflicted by COVID-19, that they may make laws aimed at the assistance of these groups, creating the means that help and encourage them to overcome this present situation with dignity and respect. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For doctors, nurses, social workers, psychologists, scientists, and all who work to contain this pandemic, may they, with their families, be protected so that they continue to care with patience and love for those infected with the virus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people who, like us, have lost one or more loved ones due to the pandemic, may we be granted acceptance, comfort, and hope in these moments of sadness and pain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us here and for our relatives that have passed along, that although we are scattered by our circumstances and pain, we may find ourselves united in prayer and in the same spirit, we pray for eternal rest where they will be light, happiness, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious Father, listen to the prayers that we humbly offer you in this moment of pain, so that we may express our faith and our trust. Strengthen us and guide us so that we do not falter during this pandemic. May it come to an end soon, and may we always walk with confidence in the promise that you are with us always until the end of the world. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And now let us pray in the words that our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Almighty God, we pray to you for our loved ones who now rest in your presence. We thank you for all the gifts you have given them in this life and for the moments they shared with us in time. May they be led to you by your angels and through the intercession of the saints, sleep the dream of peace until one day we meet again and so experience the promise of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Say to the Lord, my prayer. Thank you.